Good evening and thank you for this invitation to the Colloquio of Santiago. I would like to talk about dreams, the changes to make dreams real, and eco-museums as a tool to empower communities to change reality. I'll try to explain also how eco-museums link local and global sustainability. Eco-museums are spread all over the world, but I'll talk about Italian eco-museums that I know better than others. Let's start from dreams. Everyone has dreams. When I was a young ecologist, I dreamed a better environment. Because of the industrialization, the place where I lived near Milan in Italy was characterized by the pollution of air, water, and soil. So I wished a better environment. There are also global dreams, like the Museo Integral of the Santiago de Chile meeting in 1972. There are also community dreams and national dreams. Many Italian dreams became law when the Republic Constitution was approved in 1947. The Constitution itself is a dream to achieve every day. Italian eco-museums are tools to realize some of the Constitution dreams. We can explain what is an eco-museum in Italy through the Italian Constitution dreams. We can explain that is a practice of active citizenship aimed to the care of the landscape and heritage and to contributing to the material and spiritual progress of society and the full development of the human person. How can we make dreams real and inspire future? We need permanent change of present. Eco-museum can inspire people to address their needs for change. To make or inspire changes, dreams have to be followed by action in presence of a breeding ground. According to Hugh Devarin, the living heritage is the humus, the breeding ground and the root of the future. Everybody should take charge of heritage through a process of governance. Participation processes can release energy and build community for cultural, social, and economic change and sustainable local development. Therefore, both a breeding ground, the cultural heritage, and a voluntary process of governance, the participation, are needed to make permanent changes of the present, inspire future, make dreams true. But what kind of participation? We should go up on the scale of the participation to the people empowerment. That is, make people able to carry out projects for the common interest. When you go up on the participation scale, the staircase became more and more unstable. This is the reason why we should make the steps bigger by involving the interested stakeholders. Obtained result can be read in the relation to the changes that were produced or triggered within the community. First of all, methodological changes concerning the way work is done. Then, cultural changes, in particular linked to the relational and social dimension. And finally, physical changes, the increasing quality of landscape and environment. In the last year, and also this year because of the pandemic, in Italy we found out about a reduction of private assets. For this reason, we have to better recognize and enhance common goods and heritage. But we have two problems. The first, the community does not often recognize common goods as community heritage. The second, the governance model is often based on the logic of bipolar administration. This is a model of governance with administrators versus administered. It does not allow the community to mobilize its resources. The community cannot express ideas and implementations and changes for the solution of complex problems. The innovation of tradition and a participation process are needed. In 2014, Italian Ecomuseums found a national network and shared a strategic manifesto. I would like that you come and visit Italy, but for now let's go in Italy only virtually. We go in Italy to analyze how Italian Ecomuseums has tried to address changes in their territories. Let's go. Our Italian trip will have 11 stops to discover 11 ways to inspire future. Let's start with my Ecomuseum. We are in the north of Italy, in Lombardy region. The Landscape Ecomuseum of Parabiago was born to answer to the placelessness syndrome. Citizens do not appreciate the small-scale heritage that characterize the city landscape. Near Parabiago there is the North Milan Urban Ecomuseums. This picture shows the Brega Bunker, that is a site of the Ecomuseum. This Ecomuseum is a cultural institution managed by an association that involves institutions at different levels. It was recognized by the Lombardy region and it works with the municipalities in the north of Milan. Put landscape at the center. We are now on Alps in Trentino province with a beautiful landscape. The Ecomuseum of the Giudicaria studies, conserves, enhances and shows the community heritage, especially the landscape. Plan and act with citizens continuously. The Ecomuseum is a museum of community. It is legitimated by the participation of citizens. The Ecomuseum of Argenta is in Emilia-Romagna region, inside the River Po Plain, the bigger in Italy. This Ecomuseum plans and works not only for, but also with the community. This is in accordance with the logic of active citizenship and the subsidiarity principle. In the center of Italy, the Ecomuseum of Casentino realized the Ecomuseum Action Plan using a useful tool, these parish maps. The parish map is a participatory mapping of a landscape resulting from a shared reading of the tangible and intangible heritage. They are useful and beautiful. This Ecomuseum also realized the so-called Bank of Memory. It is a website that records tradition and oral and intangible memory. Let's return in northern Italy. All media realized by the Grigne Ecomuseum are published under an open license and are free for sharing and adapting. This Ecomuseum, like many other in Italy, shared a lot of media in times of pandemia. help institution to plan. Now we are in the south of Italy, in Puglia region, with a beautiful rural landscape. Here, Ecomuseums realize many parish maps to recognize the heritage and the action about its good use. Puglia region used this work to make the landscape master plan. In Italy, landscape is a very important heritage element. We go in Piemonte region where Ecomuseum of Valle Elvo Serra realized action for the care, the interpretation, and the good use of landscape. Taking care of the stakeholders network and the large use of the subsidiarity principle are very important goals for Italian Ecomuseum. This is because, thanks to stakeholders, some heritage elements can get new life or new uses in order to improve social, environmental, and economic development. What kind of development am I talking about? The Ecomuseum focus on sustainable development with a holistic vision. I'll show you an example from the Ecomuseum that I managed, the Parabiago Ecomuseum, in 2015, empowered many local stakeholders to activate the circular economy of the Parabiago brand. This project was called Cultivate Parabiago by Eating. This is the complex scheme of the circular economy of the brand of Parabiago. Don't worry, I'll try to explain it in detail. Loaves are made in local bakeries with whole wheat flour. They are produced with sourdough, Parabiago water and salt. The flour, made from soft wheat of an ancient variety called San Pastore, is stone milled in the last water mill in the area. 170 hectares of agriculture field are cultivated with the conservative agriculture. This agriculture impacts in a minimum manner on the ground. It reduces CO2 emissions, preserves biodiversity and humus, and provides cover crops after the harvest. The fields are fertilized by the compost produced in a local farm from vegetable waste coming from the public and private gardens of Parabiago. Local bakeries sell the bread that is also served in school canteens. The bread was the first of many products with the trademark that certifies that they are made in Parabiago. The Ecomuseum empowered people to leave agribusiness and start agriecology. Agroecology products are both good food and ecosystem services. Ecosystem services are landscape, biodiversity, oxygen production, climate regulation, recreation and tourism, and so on. Last but not least, strategy of Italian Ecomuseums concern the link between global and local sustainability. In 2019, Italian Ecomuseum shared a strategic manifestum amendment. It stresses the role of Ecomuseum for environmental, social and economic development of communities, the achievement of the 2030 United Nations Agenda Goals for Sustainable Development, in particular the Climate Justice Goal. A new economic model is needed to link global and local sustainability. Donut economics model revolves around an holistic approach to both human and environmental well-being. Italian Ecomuseum thinks global in networking too. Since 2016, ICOM General Conference, Italian EQ Museum are managing the DROPS International Platform. It is a website for exchange and experience sharing. The platform aims at connecting EQ museums and community museums and their networks and all other heritage and landscape NGOs. I talk about Italian EQ Museum because I know them better than others. The dreams of their communities needs effort to be realized in everyday life. So do the Sustainable Development Goals. Changes are needed in the relational, social, and physical dimension to empower communities and release energy to achieve these goals. On a local scale, eco-museums all over the world are working hard to make these dreams true. I would like to end with this quote by Helder Camara, a Brazilian bishop. When we are dreaming alone, it is only a dream. When we are dreaming with others, it is the beginning of a new reality. These dreams, the dream of the Museo Integral of Santiago, dreamed by many EQ museums, communities, people all over the world, are becoming a fascinating reality. Thank you for your attention.